Today on ArtScene, we'll feature wood sculpture with Bongo Love, art to enhance learning with Think 360 Arts, a music video from a local band, and a social enterprise boutique, Hope Tank. Welcome to ArtScene. I'm Michael Gavlin, your host. First up, I've got a chainsaw artist, one of the best, Bongo Love with me, and his assistant Robert. And they're gonna do some stuff in studio, and it might get loud. Bongo, thank you for being here, man. It's so exciting to have you here.
I'm happy to be here, man.
This is kind of a different sort of art, and it's, you told me earlier, it's mainly for outdoors. I mean, can one of these be inside?
Yeah, it depends, you know. If it's too big, people, you know, sometimes people, they plant trees when they're young.
Sure.
So they grow with these trees.
Right.
Then when the tree dies, instead of hauling it all away, they leave it as a big stump. Then it stays outside.
And this is when you do your artistic
stuff
to it.
And
great.
This can be inside, can be outside.
Okay, it just depends on the size of it, obviously.
It also depends on the sealant. How do you protect it?
Okay. And what do you protect it with usually when these are done?
Sometimes you use oil.
Okay.
Sometimes when it's outside, you want to get the plastic, the polyurethane stuff.
Sure.
So it just seals it. Otherwise, Colorado, you know?
Yeah, all the weather and all the changes.
It gets too cold.
Okay. So I want you to, what are you going to do for us today? I just want you to get started. I want to hear this.
I'm going to just start playing with the face of this owl right here.
Right. Okay.
Because I'm going to make a twin owls, you know?
Okay.
I'll call them lavas.
Okay.
Just chilling right here.
They're called lavas?
Yeah. Lovers.
Oh, lovers. I'm sorry. Lovers.
Maybe their nest is down here somewhere.
Okay.
Yeah, where they're going to make
it. I'm going to let you and Robert do your thing and step back and see the magic happen. So
Sweetness.
Let's go for it.
Thank you. What up? Is the other one, that's out, yeah.
Now, really quick, what's that tool? You gave me a name for that?
This one is the eye maker.
The eye maker, okay.
So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm gonna put some eyes so you can see exactly where the eyes are.
Okay.
I'm thinking right here.
Nice.
I'm gonna put the
A minute before our next segment. Yeah. Let me ask you a quick. We can shut that down for a second, and we'll come back to that.
Yeah.
This is awesome. I mean, these tools are loud. I see the art in how you're kind of making that thing. It does more than just the eyes. You got a real good handle on that. Real quick, what got you started into this? Into sculpting, you know,
sculpting
trees.
Sculpting is, because see, I was born in Zimbabwe.
Okay.
So I came from a village where we carve rocks, actually.
Okay.
So I used to carve stones a lot.
Right.
So then I moved from a little town to a place called Binga.
Okay.
So we didn't have rocks.
Right.
So I started carving wood with chisels.
So you've been doing this for a long time since you
were... Yeah, for a very long time.
Well, it shows. You just have a command with these tools. I love it. It's exciting.
It took a long time, though, to actually be part. See, I just use this tool as an extension of my arm.
Right.
Just pretty much. So.
That's when you know you're an artist, man.
Try to remove.
Yeah. It's fun to see the development of that and how far you just went in just a few minutes. And with your, you could see where you needed that. So
because see what happened is, when you're in Africa, you know, you use boom.
Right,
boom.
It
takes a whole day. But since you get these tools, it's not like I'm molding it.
Right.
But it just cuts faster.
Yeah.
Than me just going bang.
Just
bang,
yeah. I guess there's a place for every tool, right? And depending on the time you have.
Yeah. And this tool, you have to make it yourself.
Oh, really?
They have makers, they don't make them.
Oh, okay. So you actually had to make that to get it going.
Yeah, to grind it up. And
sweet. Well, we're going to be back with you in studio for more of this. And we can't wait to see that. Back with more of Bongo and what he's doing. And see where the sculpture goes right here in studio. Do you see all that smoke? That's crazy. But first, let's look at a program using art to enhance learning. Think 360 Arts.
The city and county has been impacted by our work through just how many children we've touched in through the arts and creativity. We teach kids every single day about how creativity can be part of their learning and their lives.
The last year we provided services to over 24,000 kids, and we had over 600 teachers that we impacted with our professional development programs.
I've always been a big believer in arts really changing and impacting kids, and I think a lot of it, what we do is just the experience itself, but I think we're also engaging kids in wanting to be in school and wanting to learn and expressing themselves.
The important thing that we do is we give jobs to artists, but we give them a professional wage and they get to work in the classroom with kids. And it's an incredible mission. I mean, you can't go against that mission. It's just so exciting to see the desire of kids to work with professional artists.
I think Denver is on its way to being a really impressive cultural city. We have so many different things going on, and our goal is really just to keep the next generation engaged in the arts and engaged in creativity, and so that's what we do every day.
With me now is Jay Seller from Think 360 Arts. Welcome, Jay. So glad to have you on the program.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it. So tell us a little bit more about what Think 360 Arts is and what's the mission?
So Think 360 Arts puts artists in the classroom. That's our main focus, is artists in the classroom. We have 63 artists on our roster,
nice.
And we place them into the classroom for, it can be a one-off where it's like one session, workshop, or they could do a residency of 2, 3, 4 weeks and more.
Okay, so I saw something on when I watched a video where artists obviously go in and they're teaching teachers, or they're really, who are the people watching the workshops? Who's a part of
that? Great question. So we do two things. One is we work with students where the artist comes into the classroom, and then they work with students, and the teacher's always present.
Okay.
And the teacher's a part of that planning. We always tie it into the standards, the state standards in arts. or in whatever subject matter we're in.
Okay.
We do a lot with the core curriculum.
Okay.
So it's math classes, science classes, you name it, English classes.
Those that you have to have.
Exactly, so exactly. And then we also do the arts too.
Wonderful.
A second component we do is professional development for teachers.
And that's the one I saw. So that's where I was thinking, okay, so that's wonderful. And what I witnessed in the video is how passionate those teachers were to learn something new that they didn't realize, and how much more, you know, effective they were in the classroom.
Correct.
Yeah. How do you choose your artists? What's the
protocol? We have we do a call through West Staff, so it's an open call for artists to sign up, and then they're juried, and then they're selected for going to the classroom. We do a required professional development training with them.
Okay.
So it's, you know, the pedagogy of the classroom environment, student behavior, how to handle classroom behavior, and we try to teach them all of that, the acronyms that are being used in public education, and private and, you know, charter schools, et cetera.
So they don't have to know that, but you really do that training.
Yes.
And so what are some of the bases you choose artists? I mean, is it based on work and portfolio or just their experience and their craft?
So it's mostly their what they can bring to the table with working with kids. And we have digital artists, we have creative writing artists, storytellers, African drumming, visual artists, 3D sculpture, installations, I mean, you name it.
Right.
We've got them all.
The whole
So the teacher will call us, and sometimes the teacher has a focus that they're not really sure.
Okay.
And then we will meet with them during a planning session, and we'll bring in an artist.
Okay.
And we'll kind of see if this is the right direction, right feel for their school.
Okay, nice. And how far back does Think 360 Arts go? What's sort of the history of it? Give me a little
short. We're over 50 years old, and we've been in Denver for a long time. We're an affiliate of Young Audiences, and a lot of people know that national brand. And so that's where we've been doing our work here in the Colorado State.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now, you said you have a roster of artists. Does that change a lot? Do you kind of, how long do you keep artists
so
on?
So there is always attrition. There's turnover.
Sure.
And since we have an open call, new artists are joining our roster, you know, on a yearly basis. We usually bring in about 5 to 10 new artists a year, I would say.
Oh, great. That's
and so
great.
Then there's some that will drop off or, you know, go different ways or move or whatever.
And it sort of keeps it fresh, though, it sounds
Because
you always want that. Yeah. So where is Arts360's future? What's it going to look like? Is it just the continuation of the same? What's the plan?
So one, you know, we have the two components of arts in the classroom, professional development for teachers, and the third thing we do is kind of networking and communication with the state.
Okay.
And that's kind of keeping teachers abreast of what's happening.
Right.
Giving awards to schools for outstanding arts programs.
Oh, nice.
Awards to teachers for outstanding arts programs, and then obviously to artists themselves.
So So it sounds like it's really about continuing to recognize how important arts is, and just always staying on top of it, because there's always these developing things, new tools. You talked about graphic design. And there's always going to be new ways of creating. So it sounds like you're always on top of that.
Yes.
You know, keep you there. I love it. I love it. Jay, thank you so much.
What
you're doing is so important, and I know people out there are just loving it, and just continue to do what you're doing.
Thanks
for being with us. I really appreciate it. More wood sculpture when we return. And we're back on ArtScene. And now here's a music video from one of Denver's great local bands.
Maybe I can't.
You can see more great music on Denver Loft Sessions right here on Denver 8 TV. Next up, a very cool social enterprise boutique, Hope Tank.
I always believed that this was going to be a really big, important movement. I started out in the Santa Fe Arts District. We had a very small space. I started with 10 artists. Fast forward 3.5 years later, I have about 80 local artists that we work with. The growth with this business has been kind of overwhelming, honestly, in a good way.
I met Erica right here, actually right over at the register. I first came into Hope Tank and thought, what is this? Literally, like, what is going on here?
We have local artists who choose a charity that they designate to have a portion of the proceeds go to, and they and I split that donation.
It really is like this hub for people to experience something different when they're shopping. Like, you don't normally get to give when you're buying, but this is that opportunity.
I was in the neighborhood here when I first met Erica, and I walked into the shop and saw what she was doing here, and I thought it was amazing. And I explained to her what I was doing with my Art of War project and helping veterans through the arts. And she immediately got on board and wanted to help out in any way possible, and giving us a space to run our classes here in our shop. It was just a casual environment to allow them to, you know, work on themselves, work on their own artwork. Most people don't see what Erica does, you know, behind the scenes. She's involved with a variety of different projects. One of those things is Access Gallery.
We have a whole artworks program of youth that are transitioning out of high school. They come through our programs and did job training, but what we were finding is we were training them for jobs that really didn't exist. Eric has been teaching how to really take what they do and bring it out into the community.
Each and every time I get to see her, I want to ask her about ways I can improve and make my art better and explore new ideas.
I feel like she's a caring person and she wants to see people succeed.
The work that I'm doing with veterans, with young adults with disabilities, and getting them to be a part of the conversation around commerce, it can't just be a feel-good thing. It has to be a program. There has to be a timeline and a strategy and an agenda. It's not just about the store.
The reason she created the store is because she cares so much.
She, you know, bends over backwards for us and promotes us, you know, as much as you possibly can.
We love Erica at VSA, and I hope we get to continue working with Erica for a long time.
The whole goal of the store is that it becomes a portal for this other work in the community. And so when people come in, they know that they can get aligned with something bigger.
If she's doing stuff like winning awards, then she must be doing something incredibly right.
Now that was a great program. Time to check out how Bongo is doing in our studio. How's this going?
You want to try for the eyes on?
I'd love to try
to handle this tool. Let's try to put them as close as we can.
Okay.
So just hold it like this.
All right.
You come in, your thumb is your pivot.
Right.
So you just push it in and like that.
And just stay in the same spot. Okay.
Yeah, let's see what you got.
Let's see what I got. Let's do this. I'm going to put my foot right there. Get in there. All right. Right about there?
Yeah. Round motion. Yeah. put it up.
Nice.
So now, can you match
I like
the
that.
Eye? Can you match
Can
them?
I match them?
So that it does not look squinty.
Okay.
So make sure it doesn't look squinty. So right there, it is.
Right there?
Yeah, right there. Watch it. Watch it for a while. Now wiggle it. Wiggle it. Yeah. One more.
One more?
Yeah. Just want it to look dark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Force it in there, yeah. All right, let's see. Perfect.
The eye maker. I like it.
Yeah.
That works. Okay. Thank you for letting me be a part of that. I had never done that before or used that tool.
Yeah, but
I mean,
you seem like you're an artist anyway.
So well, I am.
Holding it, like,
just a different kind of paintbrush for me, right?
Yeah.
So again, how many of these do you do a year?
How
often are you creating?
It depends, actually, because sometimes I work in people's houses a lot.
Yeah.
So not too many, as per se.
Yeah.
But then sometimes you have to make inventory for my shop when I'm selling.
Okay.
Like crafts to people.
Yeah. Yeah. And where else have you sort of shown your work besides people's yards? Have you, I mean, around?
Yeah, I've been
different places.
Yeah, I've been around the world. I've been to Europe. You know.
Right.
Some cities they host these competitions and they put the sculptures in their cities.
Yeah. So, I did read something on your website about chainsaw competitions.
Mm-hmm.
How is that? Is that a pretty heavy deal? Is it nerve-wracking? How does that?
Oh yeah, it's intense.
Because it's sort of one shot and.
Yeah, because sometimes you travel far away.
Yeah.
So you wanna take the first place and make the money and come home.
Right.
Because if you're gone for 2 weeks, you know. So yeah. But mostly it's to learn the tools, meet the friends, you know. Learn some new ideas. That's what's probably most important.
So it seems like a great community.
Oh yeah, it's big.
Yeah.
You don't believe, yeah.
I don't think people just normally know that it's that big. I mean, you see people doing this every now and again, but it's nice to know that it's kind of a growing thing and you've got a
yeah, because the
good
people,
handle on the community.
The people who showed me how to use a chainsaw.
Right.
Because I almost quit because it was so hard to just get the cuts right.
Right.
Then I told him, I'm quitting. Then this one old man said, no, you cannot quit.
Right.
I'll show you. And I told him, I don't want you to show me. Then he said, I'm going to show you for one reason, because you might teach a lot of people, because the chainsaw art is kind of dying.
So is it might, really?
So yeah,
it's kinda,
so you might teach a lot of people.
I'm glad you didn't quit, man.
No.
I mean, I'm really glad you didn't quit. And
well,
that's a good
too.
Lesson
actually, me too. It's like,
in still doing
oh,
it, right?
It's something else, just removing and,
right.
and having something nice like that is
yeah.
powerful.
I think people kind of see that tool might be a huge danger, but I guess once you handle it, you can,
yeah, it's
you know.
Just, every tool, safety first, you know, having
right.
my glasses on.
Right.
But with this eye maker thing, it doesn't cut, actually. It
right.
just mostly
okay.
bends, and so
right.
there's not much damage, yeah.
Good. Man, I want to thank you so much for being here in studio with me.
No, pleasure, man.
Thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. And thank you for joining us. This was exciting. Until next time, when we discover more of Denver's art scene.